Thank you, everyone, for being here today, Minister, particularly to you and your staff. I think everyone here very much appreciates the working partnership we have today and the potential for making that partnership far more effective through the kinds of discussions we're going to have today. And Anne did mention my previous speaking, engagement, which was as the lunchtime speaker at a conference of cities in Liverpool. And it was very odd to be speaking at lunch before I had breakfast. But now I've been able to use that line twice, so I'm doing quite well. First of all, I encourage you to continue this work. It's essential for Toronto and for Ontario. And I want to speak about two or three things that I hope are relevant to your goals today and for the future. First of all, Anne mentioned the Mayor's Economic Competitiveness Advisory Committee, and I share her belief that that name is awkward and difficult. And I try not to use the name anymore, but it was a process that I think is very relevant to what we're trying to do to bring training, the right kind of training, to the right kind of people, to have the right kind of workforce to ensure our collective economic success. Because that committee was a committee that I struck in which I asked the business community, labor, the academic community, and the cultural communities to come together to help us craft an economic development strategy for the City of Toronto. And that strategy is called the Agenda for Prosperity. Most of you, I'm sure, are aware of it. But there are a couple of things about how we developed that that I think are really relevant to the Toronto Workforce Innovation Group. First of all, I understand that there's legislation in some other countries that brings people together around these kinds of issues. We don't have that here. So we have to innovate ourselves and create our own structures of collaboration between the city and the province. And that's really what the Agenda for Prosperity was all about. And in a typical economic development strategy developed by a city government, we would have had our terrific civil servants write a strategy. They would have done some consulting. Then we would have gone to the business community once it was ready, and the labor community, the academic community, and said, "You think we have it right?" We did this process the other way around. And in fact, the business, academic, labor, and cultural communities wrote the strategy for us. Now, we didn't completely let it go. I chaired the committee, so there was some city input. And our staff supported the committee, as did a terrific consultant from the United Kingdom. Modern jobs are going to come in the city like Toronto from creativity. And that creativity could produce good union trade skilled jobs in building buildings. That creativity could produce research-based jobs in biotechnology, like through Mars. That could produce terrific jobs for chefs, could produce all sorts of jobs. But it's going to come through thinking and knowledge and applying that knowledge to create employment. And the fourth principle, and I was very proud that the business community not only supported this, developed it, is One Toronto, which stands for the idea that we're creating employment and prosperity not just for Bay Street, but for Main Street. We're doing this so that everybody has a real chance. And I think those, both the process of how we did that and the principles are extremely well relevant to the work that you're trying to do. I know as mayor that in Toronto, unfortunately, we are seeing certain sectors and certain people succeed and others who have similar potential not succeed. Last year, in view of the recession, I announced a number of strategies the city was undertaking to help people through the recession. And every quarter, I'm briefed on those strategies. And I was just briefed a few days ago. Heather was there. And one of the extraordinary things is that certain sectors in this city, the economy is growing. In retail, sales are actually up. Now, that's not surprising because 2008 was very bad, but sales are up for small business. Small business is doing better. Construction is doing very well. Financial services are doing well. But employment is not up. Unemployment is at its highest level in a very long time. And the rates of families on welfare are reaching 9%. That's an unheard of figure. We have a significant opportunity to ensure that the right kind of training meets the right kind of people who need it the most. And I'll give two simple examples. As part of our strategy, we are opening next week, Heather, a new center with the Y in Metro Hall that will train people right at Bay, at King and John. I don't know why I thought Metro Hall was on Bay Street, but there we are, close enough. Right downtown, will train people who need training the most. And it's an innovative partnership, and I'm really proud of it. And I think it's a model that we could do much more of, particularly in cooperation with our colleges like George Brown. A second model is the Partnership to Advance Youth Employment, which is a partnership that the city has with employers to bring private sector jobs to our priority neighborhoods where young people need work the most. And there have been some remarkable successes. A young man I know named Andrew Cox from Lawrence Heights was a hip-hop artist, was in his early 20s, was living with his partner, two young children, and trying to make a living as a hip-hop artist, unless you're the very best, is almost impossible. And he happened to come by our pay program accidentally, and he's now been permanently hired after an internship with a Bay Street law firm in their IT department, and they've paid for him to go back to school to get the relevant certificates. And if you speak to the law firm, they say the talent and energy and passion once the door was opened for him is unbelievable. And why was he able to do that? He was able to do that because part of pay is not just bringing jobs to a neighborhood and saying, here's a job. It is working intensely with the young people who are looking for work and helping to train them in interview skills, helping find what their talents are and bring the right kind of jobs to them, and helping ensure that we don't just open the door, but we open it with some assistance. When we understand that our training has to meet the right needs, that in partnership between the province and the city, we can identify those needs, and with the right partners at the table from the academic sector, the community sector, from labor and business, we can identify those needs and have the training be where it's needed the most as quickly as possible. I know we can succeed in that because we succeeded in that with the Agenda for Prosperity, and I was delighted when you asked me to come today to bring greetings. So on behalf of all of my colleagues at City Council and the people of Toronto, I want to say thank you for bringing together the Toronto Workforce Innovation Group. You've got the right approach, and I know we will succeed together. Thank you very much.